Hello everyone, in this particular video we are going to discuss what was my entire routine for the entire day during my CA final or intermediate or CPT leave period and what I used to do in my break period. Since most of you were asking me to prepare a detailed video on this particular topic, here I am preparing the same. So let's watch this entire video in order to understand the daily timetable which can help all of you to study for 12 hours in one day. So first of all, I'd just like to share my CA final leave period in detail. I used to wake up at 5 a.m. and I used to start study from 5:30 a.m. So remember one thing in mind, either you have to sleep early or you have to sleep late depending on whether you are a morning studier or you're a night studier. One advice which I would like to give all of you is that keep your sleeping and the time of waking up fixed. If you're going to sleep at 10 p.m. or 9 p.m. or 11 p.m. or 3 a.m. whatever the time be, you have to ensure that you sleep at that particular time each and every day so that you wake up on the same time each and every day. What happens is that if you're going to change your sleeping and waking up time, then this is going to create disturbance because your body is not adapted to that particular time period. So if you fix your time period, that is definitely going to help all of you. So I had fixed my time period. I used to sleep by 10 p.m. and I used to wake up at 5 a.m. in the morning. So during the first 2 to 3 hours, that was a very effective study for me, and in that 2 or 3 hours of sitting, my entire concentration was there on studies itself and no other distractions or no other thoughts used to linger in my mind. So remember one thing, what you should do in order to study effectively is that first of all, lock yourself in a room where no one is present except you and your books. Once you lock yourself up in a room and just study with a lot of concentration, trust me, no distraction or no external thought would come in your mind. Usually what happens is that for a student, it becomes very difficult at the outset itself to study for 2 longer hours without any distraction. So one advice which I would like to give all of you is that if it is not possible for you to study for 2 longer hours, I know it takes a lot of time to reach to that level wherein you can study for 2 longer hours without any distraction at all. So what you can do is that you should just study for 30 to 35 minutes or maybe 45 minutes. Take a 5-minute break. In that particular break, don't watch a movie, don't go on Instagram or don't go on social media. Instead, in that break period, go for a walk or just spend time with your family so that your mind is refreshed and once again, you are back with that same amount of concentration. So you can just increase this period gradually from 30 or 45 minutes to 1 hour. So in the period of 2 hours, like I used to sit for 2 hours, and in these 2 hours, I used to take a break of 5 minutes after 1 hour. After 1 hour, I just used to go outside my room and I used to spend time with my family, or I just used to go for a walk for 5 minutes. So I used to take a 5 minute break, or I used to take a 5 minute power nap. And then after that particular 5 minute nap, I used to again sit with the same amount of concentration which I was sitting earlier. So remember this thing in mind, that if you're not able to sit for 2 hours straight away, then try to sit for at least 45 to 50 minutes, take a 5 minute nap or take a 5 minute break, and then once again sit for 1 hour continuously. So I wouldn't consider this 5 minutes as break, but then I would consider this as a time which you are investing in order to study dedicatedly and consistently for the next 1 hour. So this is how I used to study. Now regarding the breaks which I used to take after 2 hours, I used to take 15 to 20 minutes of break after my 2 hours of slots. So after 5:30 to 7:30, at 7:30 a.m. I used to go to take the shower, and then I used to study back from 8:30 after having my breakfast. So I used to study from 8:30 to 10:30, then 11:30 to 1:30, then 2:30 to 4:30. So these were the slots of 2 hours each, and I had 6 slots of 2 hours each in my entire leave period. So within those slots, wherever there's a gap of 1 hour or wherever there's a gap of 15 to 20 minutes, I used to spend time with my family, or else I used to go for a walk, or else I used to do those things which won't distract my mind. I used to listen to some meditation music which does not have any lyrics, and it just used to refresh my mind completely. So like, be aware about the fact that you don't have to listen to any music, or you don't have to listen to any particular movie or any dialogue which will just distract your mind. Instead, you have to listen to those particular things which are going to increase your concentration and which are going to increase your efficiency and effectiveness of studying. So this is the thing which I would like to tell all of you, is that during those break periods, avoid watching any kind of movies or avoid playing any kind of games which are going to distract you and which won't be possible in those 15 minutes itself. So do those things which will just refresh your mind and which will not take more than 15 minutes of your time. So this is the strategy which I had followed in my break period. And because of this, I used to study for 12 hours in one day without any distraction. One more piece of advice which I would like to give all of you is that your sitting place should be constant. Now this might be debatable and there might be conflicting views on this, but what my reason here is that if you are sitting on one particular chair itself, like I used to sit on that chair like throughout my CA final and intermediate and CPD leave period, this was the chair where like I used to sit and I used to study on this particular chair itself. So what happens is that when you're going on that particular chair, your mind knows that you have to study for the next 1 hour or next 2 hours. See, take an easy example. If you're going on a bed, if you're going to study on a bed, automatically your mind will feel that, let's sleep now, I'm on a bed, it is so comfortable, you'll feel like sleeping. So therefore, I never studied on my bed and I used to study on that chair itself, because once I sat on that chair, my mind was giving me this message that you have to study now for the next 1 hour or next 2 hours. So keep your study place fixed and don't constantly change your study places at all, because if you constantly change your study places, that is going to create disturbance for you. Trust me, I've experienced. I used to study in a library and I used to sit on different chairs and different parts of the library. That used to create some kind of disturbance and I didn't like that. In order to increase my focus and efficiency, I just shifted from that library to my home, to my room itself. I used to lock myself up and I used to sit on that chair for 2 straight hours. So this is a very important advice which I would like to tell all of you. Now apart from this, what kept me motivated throughout my leave period was that I always used to think about my parents. So think about your mom who used to wake up at 5 a.m. in the morning and prepare your tiffin in your articleship days. Think about your dad who used to support you all the time. So this was the thought which used to keep coming in my mind and I used to think that I have to make my parents proud. So I'll just share one of the incident as well. My father, he was unable to clear his CA examinations due to luck or fortune, whatever you call. But then it was my dream to become a CA so that his dream of becoming a CA gets fulfilled. So of course, any parent in the world would want their child to go beyond what they have achieved in their life. So this was the thought which used to come in my mind, and with this particular thought itself, I used to get motivated and automatically my body used to study for 12 hours in one day. So my body was automatically adopted to study for 12 hours in one day. Even if I used to study 1 hour lesser, my mind used to get frustrated and I used to feel like shit, I have lost 1 hour of the entire day. So keep this thought in mind while studying. And I know that this particular COVID pandemic has created a lot of negativity around you, but trust me, you have to expect the unexpected, and despite the unexpected, you have to try to achieve your goal. So remember this thought in your mind that COVID-19 is an unexpected situation, but despite this unexpected situation, you have to achieve your goal. Then and only then people around you would recognize you and value you. If you keep this particular attitude, trust me, no particular disturbance or no particular externality is going to affect your mindset and affect your thoughts. So I think this particular video would be useful for all of you in terms of deciding your study strategy and the breaks and the activities which you should do in your breaks. Of course, you should indulge in any particular hobby, like if you like to play guitar, if you like to play cricket, but then ensure that you don't end up playing a lot of time and consuming a lot of time in that hobby. Okay, you have to do that particular hobby which is not going to distract you, which you are not going to think of while studying, and which is just going to rejuvenate your body from top to bottom. At this point of time, I'd like to thank Unacademy for sponsoring the video. For CA Foundation and CA Intermediate students, there is a last lap revision batch which is going to be conducted by Unacademy. So if you are interested to join this batch, it is at a very subsidized cost of ₹3,500 itself. You can very well enroll for the same using my code, that is Kushal5, to get a 10% discount. Well, in this batch, it is just a quick revision batch for intermediate group 1 and group 2, as well as for CA Foundation. You can anytime enhance the subscription as per your time and availability. So thank you so much guys for watching the video. I hope this video was useful for all of you. If you do like this particular video, share it with all your friends and subscribe to my channel so that I can create more videos for all of you. Thank you so much for watching this video. See you in the next video.